This is particularly important in our area, specifically in West Virginia, where not all the patients have access to cardiologists until they actually have an MI. So therefore, these patients should be taken care of by their primary care physicians, probably a dietitian because of the obesity. They need plus minus a rheumatologist who's initiating and following up the treatment of the RA. And very likely, same thing happens with a family practice or an internist who would follow that. Most of them, they need physical therapists. So you need a big group of people following these patients. Always, the patient will also feel more taken care of. Other than for the decision making, you would be more convincing to the patient in terms of making the decisions. And then definitely, if you refer the patients just because of having early symptoms and signs or evidence of coronary artery disease to a cardiologist, that's better than referring them for a CABG. So the earlier, the better. This way they can be intervened on early on, especially with the cardiac rehab programs and all of that. Bariatric clinic, obesity clinic also needs to be involved, especially that obesity clinic. Almost every major hospital now or every major outpatient setting does have an obesity clinic. So that is someone that needs to be involved. There is not a day where in the clinic you do not refer at least two patients to obesity clinic, whether they are RA positive or SLE positive or whatever is that autoimmune disease they have.